Mommy, you want to put your Bible back there?
Yeah.
You keeping this tablet back here?
Yeah, because I brought it.
Yeah, because I can hear you, what you said, Mother.
Yeah, I don't know. She's talking and she's closing the phone.
My mother-in-law.
Hey.
Oh my god, y'all, already. They see, that's why you can't take kids with you. Look at them. Already. Terrible. No kids allowed.
In the Airbnb. Okay. Retry. Ready? So, y'all, we made it to the Airbnb, okay? And she vlogging. So, people talking. It's a little bathroom. What's the bathroom? And then, we're
gonna go this way.
Oh, wait. Look at this. Y'all locked it.
Girl, yeah, you know them people be coming in here. A little scary.
We got a home,
right? Okay.
Then we got the living room.
Okay. TV with the fake kitchen. Little plant.
It's called a succulent.
Okay.
Teach me something. We got a bedroom right here.
Hold up. You forgot the bathroom.
Oh, my bad.
Hold up.
Boom. Boom.
Picture ready.
Boom. What? Boom. Okay. That's what my picture's about to be. Okay. This is the bathroom. Look at.
Yeah, it's gonna be here for the weekend.
Just wait, part two.
Are we now going upstairs?
Okay. Yeah, because you know,
sometimes
you
have to
Okay.
Let's
go upstairs.
Up these stairs. Let's go
upstairs, shall we? Oh, I'm walking in the water.
Okay, so we go upstairs.
We got a living room, a TV,
and
then
we got a second bedroom.
Pretty nice, okay.
And then we got the bunk beds.
But they annoying
selves,
though.
And then we got another bathroom, you feel me? All the bathrooms really got good light, you feel me?
But it's okay, though.
Because we're going to be downstairs.
It's big. Ooh, what's this, poop?
Then we got another bedroom.
What? Who bedroom is this?
We got another bedroom.
What?
Okay.
Okay, y'all. So, I know I missed. I didn't tell y'all a lot of information. And I know me and Cam haven't made a video in a long time. Okay, so he left for BMT Air Force. For the ones who don't know already, he left for boot camp November 19th, and he graduates this Friday, January 17th. But tomorrow they do a coin ceremony and stuff, so we get to see him tomorrow. And we get to see him run in the morning. Tomorrow at like 6, 7 o'clock in the morning. So I'm very excited for that. And it's been so long, y'all. Well, it really went by quick. Like, it felt like we just dropped him off like 2 weeks ago. But I'm really excited. And so, We came here a night before Thursday, tomorrow. We got our little house to stay in until Sunday. We get to see him Thursday through Sunday. So I'm excited for that. And y'all stay tuned in. I'm gonna record him graduating Friday and everything tomorrow. This is gonna be an experience.
Good morning, y'all. So it is about 5:40. And we are already about to head out to the base. Cause we heard it's gonna be a really long line. So trying to get there. Just got on this Air Force shirt. We've learned so much.
Everything's going by so fast now. We've become a real team. When we first got here, we made a lot of mistakes, but now our flight's really coming together.
We've passed all our final exams, and we are so ready to become airmen.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
They ain't close to them.
They look like little ants, right?
you for getting us.
Thought I messed up. Oh, they busted it.
Huh?
I'm talking about what they're doing. I guess they busted it.
Please join me in prayer or silently in your own tradition. Almighty God, we ask your blessing for these young men and women who have completed a difficult and challenging period of training and discipline that has earned them the title Airman. We thank you for all the things they have made this day and this ceremony a reality. For the hard work and determination of this Airman, for the dedication, devotion, and skill of the instructors and staff, and for the love and support of family, friends, and loved ones, we give you thanks. We pray that what has been learned in this time of training has instilled in this Airman a lasting desire to maintain and defend our great nation's higher principles of freedom, justice, and dignity for all. Remind them this day of the great responsibility being placed upon their shoulders and those of their generation. Almighty God, bless them with wisdom, courage, and strength for the task.
Ladies and gentlemen, in a few minutes, the 747 Training Group's military training instructors will begin marching the graduates onto the retreat pad for today's ceremony. In the military, ceremonies are held to accord distinctive honors to national symbols or individuals on special occasions. Ceremonies are used to display the proficiency and state of training of the airmen in a command and promote teamwork and pride in the Air Force organization. Lastly, these ceremonies are used to contribute to public morale by displaying symbolically the strength and unity of the military in support of the nation. All the movements that you will see them perform today are known as drill. The purpose of drill is to enable a commander or non-commissioned officer, such as the military training instructor, the ability to move their units from one place to another in an orderly manner, to aid in the disciplinary training by instilling habits of precision and response to the leader's orders, and to provide for the development of all airmen in the practice of commanding formations. During the march on, applause is appropriate, but please limit your applause so that others may hear the narration of the squadrons and flight numbers as they pass the fire lane while entering the retreat pad. At the conclusion of the ceremony, please remain in place until the flights are dismissed. Entering the retreat pad is the 737 Training Group's Drum and Bugle Corps from the 321st Training Squadron, flights B139 and B140, led by Staff Sergeant Delvin Bradley and Technical Sergeant Jordan Gonzalez. They are performing under the direction of Master Sergeant Samuel Johnson. From the 320th Training Squadron, Flight 091, led by Technical Sergeant Jason Eubanks. From the 320th Training Squadron, Flight 092, led by Technical Sergeant Kyle Shy. From the 320th Training Squadron, Academic Excellence Flight 093, led by Staff Sergeant Christopher Curry.
Yep, that's it. He's in the second one. He's the second
one. From the 320th Training Squadron, PT Excellence Flight 094, led by Master Sergeant Elizabeth Ramos. From the 331st Training Squadron, Flight 095, led by Technical Sergeant Kenneth Rendell. From the 331st Training Squadron, Flight 096, led by Technical Sergeant David Fretzer. Airman Basic, Aaron Atkinson. Ladies and gentlemen, how about another round of applause for this exceptional airman? Pay special tribute to the men and women before us. They have successfully completed all graduation requirements and have demonstrated that they are ready to take their place as airmen in the world's greatest Air Force. We will mark their transition today from trainees to airmen by presenting them with the coveted Airman's Coin. Today's ceremony celebrates the remarkable accomplishments of this graduating class. Our nation's future rests upon the dedication of this new class of warriors who we honor today. Chief Master Sergeant Hoover will now say a few words.
Good morning. I know this rain is a bummer, but my guess is it hasn't stolen your pride, so why don't you go ahead and let them know how proud you are this morning. Here and hug their necks and let your tears flow freely, and I can promise you that time will come. But first, we have some business to take care of. Trainees, for 8.5 weeks now, your Air Force has challenged you physically, mentally, emotionally. Your military training instructor has given you everything they have to ensure you have what it takes to serve in our United States Air Force. And this morning, they say you're ready. So in a moment, that instructor will present you with an airman's coin, signifying your transition from trainee to airman. Now, it's a simple coin, but it carries with it the history and the heritage of our airmen. The men and women who have gone before you have airlifted troops and supplies into the jungles of Vietnam. They have executed precision airstrikes over the deserts of Iraq and Afghanistan. And they've delivered humanitarian aid to villages in South America and Africa. They have launched missiles and flown satellites. defended airstrips, and strengthened partnerships. They have stood in the North Pole, the South Pole, and everywhere in between. In just 72 years, we have become the most dominant air power the world has ever known. But we can be better, and you will take us there. Trainees, today you're joining a team of professionals dedicated to integrity, service, and excellence. You're joining a team rooted in dignity and respect. And you're joining a team that will now look to you to define the character of our Air Force for years to come. And we have the utmost faith in you, because every time you recite our Airman's Creed, you adamantly proclaim that you will not fail, and we believe you. As the superintendent of basic military training, I hereby acknowledge your completion of training requirements and recommend to our commander that you receive your Airman's Coin. And here's what I need you to know. From this moment forward, my wingman, you and I, and you are an airman. We are teammates. Congratulations.
Training, these men and women have developed into world-class airmen. Airmen who are disciplined, completely devoted to our Air Force core values of integrity, service before self, and excellence in all they do. And now they are prepared for what America will require of them. But I will tell you, their transition from trainee to airman would not have been possible without the dedication of the men and the women. Common American by completing basic military training. But more importantly, you have embraced our Air Force core values. I promise you, from this day forward, you will not be the same. And as a prior enlisted airman, and now the commander of basic military training, I know just how far you have gone to get to this point. And today, we recognize your accomplishments and your transformation from trainee to airman. It is said, to whom much is given, much is required. You have been given the foundational tools to be resilient, to help you to adapt and overcome the challenges you will face in life. You have been given the combat training to help you survive when you are deployed. You have been given our core values of integrity first, service before self, and excellence in all we do as your moral compass to live your life. But more importantly, you have been given the opportunity to be a part of something bigger than yourself, and that is to be part of our Air Force family. Just like our nation was built as a melting pot of different religions, cultures, backgrounds, and experiences. Our Air Force is the same. Remember, diversity is our strength, and inclusiveness is our power. So treat everyone with dignity and respect. So my challenge to each of you today is to make our Air Force better, more lethal, and more ready. Hold yourself and others to the standards and accept nothing less. Be accountable for your actions and have the courage to say something when you see something that goes against our standards. And finally, I want you to think about the significance of the oath that you're going to take tomorrow. That oath that states, I swear to support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. I want you to take a moment to think about that. And what does that really mean to you? I will tell you, our military, our Air Force, it's not a part-time job. It is 24/7, around the clock. So in closing, each of you have earned my deepest respect, and I look forward to serving beside you as America's sword and shield, united in the defense of the Constitution of the United States. Welcome to the greatest Air Force the world has ever known. Congratulations to each and every one of you. One team.
Discussion before I read it, right? For you, number one, you got to make sure you surround yourself with good people. people that are like-minded to what you want to do. Don't put yourself with people that are going the wrong direction. Because remember we said we're going to cut that fat off, right? You're not going to sit there and drag them through life. It's not your responsibility. Your responsibility is you. So moving forward for you, hey, when you make that this is what I'm going to do in my life, nothing else can distract you. You got to go for it. And then obviously with her being here, she's going to come with you too. So, but number one, just make sure you are true to yourself. And what you say is what you're going to do. Because the worst thing we can do is say something and do another, right? What you say is what you're going to do, and that's how you're going to do it. All right? Congratulations.
I gave you my heart.